Thursday, everyone. We got a cool little gasser for you guys coming up, a little 5-round action. We'll talk about that momentarily, but first things first, we're gonna talk about the warm-up. So our warm-up is gonna consist of 3 to 5 reps per side of the dynamic triangle into our single leg reach back, 3 to 5 per side, sumo squat for 3 at a 5-second lower, 2-second pause, 3-second stance. So you get a little faster stand-up, but not much. It's gonna give you a chance to really open up those hips and really work that position. Finishing off the legs a little bit for 20 seconds of side lunges, just for a nice dynamic movement. If you wanna add a tempo in there, a pause, that's up to you. You can play, just getting those legs ready, okay? 2 to 3 rounds, take that down, have some fun with it. We're gonna finish off with 3 to 5 rounds of the bottom piece here, again, just to get a little closer with the dumbbell or the kettlebell. You're gonna work with the single leg RDL, 3 per side, into your kettlebell slash dumbbell deadlift for 3. Per side, and then you're gonna move into your kettlebell swing for 5 to 10. So we're gonna have some fun with that little piece, and then finishing off with the cardio piece of choice today for 30 to 60 seconds at kind of a low to moderate intensity to start building up, getting ready for your work set. You have 3 to 5 rounds. You'll move into that work set. 5 rounds of work, run of 400 meters, oh yeah, into a kettlebell slash dumbbell swing of 30 reps, and you'll hit that for 5 rounds. So I'll have some cardio options here instead of the run underneath the workout description, just so you guys can get that squared away with whatever you want to work on today. You can have some fun with that. With the dumbbell or kettlebell swing, we'll show you single arm swings, the double, whatever you got going on there, which you want to play with. You'll hit 5 rounds of pure cardio joy. All right, let's have a good day today, all right? It's gonna be fun. To close out our day, we have 2 to 3 rounds of a single leg bridge for 5 per side. Bridge 5 to 10 and a crab extension 5 to 10 with a 10 second hold on the last rep, whatever that happens to be in that 5 to 10 rep range. Okay, so let's get you guys ready, warmed up, and set for action, all right? All right, guys, let's warm you guys up a little bit today, get you prepped and ready. We'll get our feet underneath those hips and take the arms big and tall up overhead. We're gonna reach to one side. We're gonna reach it over to the other side. We're gonna come back up overhead, scratch your back a bit, and then reach through the elbow. We're gonna come back up overhead, big stretch. Switch it over, and then big reach. And then come back up, big reach. We're gonna forward fold, we'll touch those toes. We're gonna walk up those shins, nice flat back. We'll come down, frame the foot, step it back into your lizard, and we're gonna take that inside hand all the way up, and we're gonna bring it back down, plant that hand. Outside hand is going to reach up, big stretch, back down, inside hand, big reach, and then come back down, outside hand, big reach, lower down, inside hand, big stretch, and one more time with that outside hand, big rotation. Good, plant that hand, we'll step back, and then we'll switch feet, nice and square in those hips. Inside hand, big stretch up to the sky. Come back down. Outside hand, big stretch to the sky. Back down. Back to the inside. Big scoop, big stretch. Back down. Outside hand, big stretch. Good. One more time per side. Inside hand, big looping stretch. Back down. Outside hand, big stretch. We'll plant our hands. Step back into our down dog. Set up those hips, come back into our plank. We'll tiptoe those feet up. We're gonna roll ourselves up, big tall stretch. Clasp those fingers, big press up and reach. And reach. Come back through, bring those hands down. Get you guys fired up, ready to go. So if you wanna do a little bit more warm-up stuff, pause the video, take down that nice gentle movement set, and then come back and join us. We're gonna go through that opening piece of our work set. All right, so we're gonna kickstart off our day today with our dynamic triangle. So we're just gonna get set up with a slightly wider stance, all right? Nice, solid, wide position. One toe is gonna turn to the side, the other on a slight angle. The leg of the toe is pointing straight to the side, the hand will come to the thigh, and the other hand will come straight up overhead. She's gonna pull her hips back and let that body come down, trying to stay as narrow as she can, tracing that leg down. So really focusing on drawing the hip back and almost like you're trying to stay into between two panes of glass, okay? We're gonna do one more on this side and then Linda, I'm gonna get you to go face facing the camera. Other leg this time is gonna do the work, so that toe is pointing straight to the side. The other one is on the angle. She's gonna be actively pressing into that upper hand overhead, into that overhead position as she reaches and stays strong and active here. We don't want the arm to follow the torso. We want it to be nice and stacked in that T position. So take your time with these, you guys. Really move through that full range of motion. Listen to your body and feel those hips, feel that side body, and get that good strong sensation. Okay. Our next exercise is our single leg reach back. So I want you to face this way again. She's gonna pick her balancing leg, and again, we're gonna think about a squat. So she's gonna reach her leg back, but she's gonna lower her upper body down, and then she's gonna come back up, driving through that leg. So she's gonna pull back, lowering straight down, just like a squat, and then she's gonna press through that leg and stand tall. We'll do one more on this side as she lowers down. Again, thinking about that single leg drive all the way up, and then she'll switch her feet, and she's gonna take that down again. We'll just do three on this side, nice and slow. The big thing you have to remember about the single leg reach back, you guys, is that both sides are gonna have some different bits and pieces. So you might find that you got a little bit more range on one side than the other, and that's pretty normal. So I want you guys to keep that in mind. It's not unheard of to have different ranges per leg, especially depending what your dominant leg is, balance-wise. If you've ever had some kind of knee issues on one side, you'll probably have different ranges. So just listen to your body and take it from there. Okay. Our second last exercise is that sumo squat. So Lynn's gonna get into a wide stance, toes slightly turned out, and with these squats, again, you wanna focus on pressing the knees out so that they track those toes. So she's gonna work her 5-second tempo, making sure her back stays nice and upright, and then she's gonna stand after she holds for 2 seconds, a little faster tempo than the down, but not much. So she's really taking the time to open up those hips, force those knees out a little bit more than normal, just so they track the toe and don't track inwards as she goes down into her squat. So really nice position, really nice tempo. Listen to the body, make sure we keep that back in a nice solid extension position so she stays nice and tall. Good job. From there, we have one last exercise, and that is the side lunge. And the side lunge, we'll just do 4 reps there, Luda. The toes will be turned out. You might be a wider stance than you are for the sumo squat, and that's fine. You can adjust your stance. The biggest thing, again, is we're trying to sit our hips down to our heel, so we're not going straight into the toe. We want to load the midfoot, load the hamstring, make sure we're staying out of that toe position and just staying right over those laces. Try and keep that torso as high as you can as you're going down. And just listen to your body. If you find that as you're going down, you start to hinge a lot, all right, just stop before that happens and take it to your edge. Okay. So as a quick recap for those first exercises, all right, we have our dynamic triangle, 3 to 5 per side. We have our single leg reach back, 3 to 5 to side, really tapping into that glute and hamstring balance there. Sumo squat to kind of bring it all together for 3 reps, then a 5-second lower, 2-second pause, 3-second stand, and then a side lunge for 20 seconds at your pace. You can play with that. I'm not looking for crazy amounts of reps. We're just doing that to kind of heat up those legs and work in that position. 2 to 3 rounds there. Pause the video, you guys, take it down, have fun with those, work through that, get that lower body fired up, because it's gonna do some work today. So we're gonna move forward into the next phase. Take your time, though, warm yourself up, and we're gonna get really acquainted with the kettlebell and the dumbbell, okay? So our next phase of work is our single leg RDL. So Linda, today, I would suggest you guys, you can play with this in multiple manners in terms of how you hold the dumbbell or the kettlebell. I would suggest for today, just because it's just a primer, just to hold the dumbbell in the front, just because we're just using it to heat those hamstrings up. So Linda's gonna try and stay as tall as she can in her torso, as if she has a PVC attached to her, and she's gonna try and keep that chest tall as she takes the dumbbell to her knee, and then she's gonna stand up nice and tall. So she's only taking that dumbbell to her knee or just below, she's not trying to touch it to the floor, she's trying to work that body position so she stays in a nice, long extension position, all right? Super challenging to balance in, and this is one of those exercises we just have to listen to our body. So I'd rather see you take this partial range than work on going all necessarily worrying about touching the floor, but if she can go there, and she's just gonna stand tall. We're just using this as a chance to prime up the hinge, prime up those hamstrings and glutes a bit more to get you ready for those more dynamic swings, okay? If you're using a kettlebell for this, you can do your RDLs with a kettlebell, you can do all of these with a kettlebell instead of a dumbbell, but if you do have only a dumbbell at home, this is perfect. Just take it as deep as you feel comfortable, working on that nice hip hinge, and again, taking it as deep as you feel comfortable, okay? So working that 3 rep per side, single arm dumbbell, and just having some fun with it. Our next exercise is just getting more dynamics. We're gonna work on that little hinge, but with the kettlebell swing. So Linda's gonna start by holding, doing the single arm kettlebell swing, so she's gonna do a couple per side. So she's gonna get into that hinge and that explosive open. And you can take this dumbbell as high or as low as you need to maintain control in that overhead position. The biggest thing is that we're staying square in our torso and we're not rotating with this single arm swing. I really like these, and if you're doing these, what I would do is just 15 on one side, 15 on the other side in the workout, and then take it down that way. If you're gonna choose to do one of the other options, which we're gonna move into right now, which is the double, she can choose to hold the bell, all right, so holding the bell underneath like a handle, and just working on that same hip hinge. So regardless of the style of holding the dumbbell, Linda's body position and mechanics stay the same, all right? So we're hitting that good explosive hinge, that kind of jumping action where we don't actually leave the ground, and we're just coming up to that standing tall position, really fighting the urge to push forward in that hyperextension. We go back and we stand, nice and strong, okay? So another option with the dumbbell, she can hold it like a golf club. If you just want to show it two swings, that's fine. It's just another way to hold the dumbbell. It gives you a little bit more stability on it. That will cut down on your range of motion as well. You'll only be able to get it just above the shoulder with that height, but that's okay as well. So whatever you feel comfortable with, that's what I want you to take down, you guys. All right? From there, all right, we have a cardio piece of choice. So I don't want you to panic about this. In terms of the cardio piece of choice, you're gonna do whatever you plan on doing in the workout. We're gonna take it at a moderate to lower intensity for about 30 to 60 seconds, just to get a feel for it. So if you're planning on skipping, getting your rhythm in, going for a run, getting your running legs under you, row, same idea, getting your rowing legs under you. So I'll put some options down there for you guys to play with and have fun with. The wall run option will be there as well, so you can do that wall run, but I'll have a time frame for you guys in there for that, okay? So pause the video, take down these rounds. This is, again, getting comfortable with that kettlebell, getting comfortable with that dumbbell, just kind of making sure the positions are there, heating up the glutes and the hamstrings. Single leg RDL, 3 per side, kettlebell slash dumbbell deadlift, 3 per side, and then a kettlebell swing for 5 to 10 reps, followed by the cardio piece of your choice, 30 to 60 seconds for 3 to 5 rounds. Take that through, get yourself fired up, ready to go, and then pause this video, rock those rounds, and come to us that 5 rounder right here. So we're not gonna make Linda do these exercises again because she just did a bunch. But what we have for you guys is 5 rounds of work. I'll have a round option in the workout description as well. But we have 5 rounds of work, 400 meter run for your cardio piece of choice, all right? And then you finish off with 30 kettlebell slash dumbbell swings, all right? So picking whatever style of swing you'd like to do, that's the kind of swing you're gonna take down in the workout. Choosing the single arm dumbbell swing, 15 on one side, 15 on the other side, and then continue with that cardio piece. Rock that for your 5 rounds. Have some fun with it. It's gonna be a good time. I'm excited. Pause the video, take it down, have fun with this one. Your heart rate's gonna be up there. That's okay, that's why we do what we do. So have fun with it, pace it out, rest as you need to, focus on good back and kettlebell swing mechanics. That is crucial, okay? Pause it, come back to us. We're gonna take you through this little hip opener and we'll go over it, all right? So our last little piece that's gonna guide you into your cool down is going to be a few little bridges, all right? And style of bridges. So Linda's gonna lay on her back. She's gonna work through her single leg bridge. So she's gonna get herself laying on her back, get herself set up. One leg is gonna come up to the sky. She's gonna get set. step through the arms. She's gonna squeeze and lift those hips up and then lower down. We'll just do three. So in this, again, she's working on getting as high as she can maintain her level hip position. Her head is not taking any of the external body weight. It's her shoulders and her feet that are her base points. Your head is touching the floor, but your head and neck are not taking the weight of your body. Okay, super important. We're also not rotating, so going as too high so that we rotate to one side, all right, and toward our body. We're just going to where we can go. From there, we're gonna go into a double leg bridge, so same idea. We're gonna squeeze the glutes, lift the hips, staying in that nice position with the ribs, and then lower down. So she'll take down, let's say, 5 to 10 reps, or just three, working on coming up as high as she feels comfortable, and then lowering. And on her last rep, she's gonna squeeze up and hold. And she'll just hold there for 10 seconds, controlling, breathing, and then she'd lower back down. All right, so nice and steady through those work sets, anywhere from 5 to 10 reps. Whatever your last rep happens to be, hold for 10 seconds, work on opening up those hips. Our last exercise is going to touch on the shoulder and the hips. So we're going to work on our crab extension. So crab extension is a great strengthener. It's also a nice cool down slash strengthening exercise. So Linda's fingers right now are pointing back. You can go to the side or point them towards your toes, or your heels, I should say, depending on where you feel that sensation. Fingers to the outside, a little bit more neutral, but neither is right nor wrong. Just a little bit different. As Linda squeezes her glutes, she lifts her hips up, and she's getting pretty decent range of motion for here and getting pretty flat. So it's okay if you can't get that high. Your shoulders or your hips are gonna be the deciding factor in this in terms of how high you get. Okay, so just listen to your body, and by the time you get to that last rep, you might surprise yourself and be a little higher than you were when you first started. So take advantage of that. On that last rep, she's gonna work on maintaining that position at the top for 10 seconds, making sure she's not dumping into the shoulders, shifting or anything, just working on squeezing, holding, and lowering down. That 10 seconds can feel like an eternity, so just be prepared. That's a tough one, but it's really nice in terms of the shoulder opener, chest opener, and get those hips open, okay? So take that down 2 to 3 rounds. Use that to lead into your cool down. If you want to focus your time on anything in the cool down today, kneeling hip stretch, a little bit of rotation or gentle rotation work, just get yourself moving, get those hips going. But that's a nice place to start and a nice place to kind of lead into your cool down for the day. Okay? Good luck with this one, you guys. It's going to be a gasser. Be prepared. Those 400s are not meant to be the fastest 400s you've ever ran, so please keep that in mind. The first couple steps, if you're running, are going to be challenging coming out of those kettlebell swings. Actually, not just running. Whatever cardio piece you choose, those first couple strokes or jumps, run steps, are gonna feel a little bit more labored, but listen to your body, ease in, and then pick up the pace as you feel you can, okay? Let me know how this one goes, you guys. I'm curious to hear. Super pumped to hear about this